I was married. I got four lovely kids. Unfortunately, 2018, she told me it was over. She tried everything to get me out. She eventually did. I was on the streets for 4 months. There's a lot of people said to me, why didn't you turn to drink? Why didn't you turn to drugs? And to be honest, I just thought, I want to be able to see my kids again. The Archer Project, they were there to help pick up the pieces. They helped me come to terms with the situation, because like I say, I've never been on the streets. I was finding it hard at times, and there were times when I didn't think I'd see my kids ever again. And there were times when things did go through my mind that I wanted to end it and all this lot. But I just kept thinking, no, if you want to see your kids, Paul, you're going to have to pull through this, you're going to have to fight through it. And Archer Project were there to help me through that. And then they got in touch with the housing, and them and the housing got me this flat. The lady that took me up to the flat to show me around, she says, and where are you stopping tonight? And I told her, I says, oh, I'll be under my bridge. She went, what do you mean? I says, well, that's where I've been sleeping, under a bridge. She went, no, you're not. So she told me, she goes, as soon as we've finished here, get down to housing and sign for keys and you can stop here tonight. I started at the Archer Project in 2019, and it was just somewhere where some of the people could go after breakfast till 12 o'clock. They could play pool and it was supervised and they could make their own drinks. Eventually they just asked me, do you want to take over this? So I said yeah, and I started doing that, and I've just been here ever since. Before I came homeless, if I saw somebody sat outside a shop begging for money, I'd just cross over. I wouldn't even bother walking past them. I'd just cross over, and since I've been on the streets myself, I'll just go up to them. I'll go and get them a sandwich if I've got any money, or I'll just sit and talk to them. I'll just sit there and I'll talk to them and communicate with them. There was one time I remember, there was a bloke sat outside Sainsbury's on High Street, and I walked down one day and he'd tried cutting his wrist, and I said to him, I says, and what have you done there? He says, oh, I'd had enough yesterday, this and over. I says, you don't see me like that, and I don't see you like that. And I went down to him, and I says to him, what are we? We're street people, what are we? And he turned around and goes, we're warriors. And I says, yeah, we're warriors. And warriors don't do stupid things like that. And I saw him about 2 weeks later in the canteen, and he was supposed to have been seeing two women, social care, I think it were, and he were kicking off. And I just walked in and I heard him kicking off, saying, I don't want to speak to him, they don't do me no good, I don't want to. And I just walked up behind him and I went, listen, we're warriors, they've come to help you. And he went, oh, all right. And I let him come to talk to him. So it's like that friendship and the commitment between each other and the respect. I wish I could do more, but me at the moment being unemployed, I can't. But people that take themselves out to bring food, bring clothes and stuff like that, I'm just so glad that there's a lot of people out there that will do things like that for charity. And I hold my hands up to them.